everyone. This is Assistant Professor Ishani Trivedi from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today we are going to discuss regarding the various precast concrete elements, right? In the previous session, we discussed about what is precast construction, what is the sequence of construction. We discussed about some examples as well and how the assembly makes your full total structure, right? And as I said, it is the one of the methods of modern construction, ongoing practice in the construction industry, right? So now let us try to discuss that what are the different precast concrete elements that can be made for a building. So here we have in all four different types of, right? We are going to have four categories regarding the precast concrete elements. We already know what is precast, right? So the first element which we have is precast concrete slabs. Now slab means the floor. So the construction of the slab, meaning the slabs will be casted, it will be precast on the manufacturing unit, on the manufacturing side, and it will be directly transported and fitted. It will be fabricated on the building, on the site, right? Next, second element which we have is precast concrete beams and girders. Now, beam is a supporting element, which we know that. And how is your load transfer mechanism? Your load comes on the slab. From slab, it is transferred to the beam. From beam to the column, column to the foundation or the footing, and then to the surrounding subsoil, right? This is the load mechanism which we follow in the framed structures. So if you see, then the floor, beam, column, so then we have floor means slab, beam, column, and the wall, right? Also foundation, but I don't think we can consider it right now, but the walls can be also made precast for RCC. So if you see that this sequence which is followed itself becomes the precast concrete elements, various elements, right? The third which we have is precast concrete wall panels and columns, right? So wall panels, this comes in the vertical sections. The above two which we saw were in the horizontal sections. The slab is a horizontal member, beams and girders are supporting members, once again horizontal. In the vertical members which we have is the walls, wall panels, right? I have shown you an image regarding the precast concrete wall panels in the previous session itself, how it is constructed and the opening space is left, and the columns which you already know what is a column, right? Next which we have is other members. So other members includes the miscellaneous ones, that is the stairs or these are unique shapes or say any kind of circular or asymmetrical forms, structural members. You can consider all of them in the other members. The miscellaneous ones, stair also comes in the miscellaneous ones, but there are lots of drawbacks regarding the precast staircase or stair. Let us try to understand all of these elements in detail in today's session. Right, moving forward. So the first which we are going to discuss is the precast concrete slabs. Now let me show you certain different types of slabs which we can make with the help of say precast construction, right? So the first one which we have is a flat slab. The second which we have is a hollow core slab. The third one which we have is a double T slab. So let us try to understand each of them. First one, flat slab. Flat slab is the most simple type of construction. Longitudinal bars will be provided, meaning the reinforcement will be provided. Specially designed formwork and molds will be made, and then the slab will be casted layer by layer, and the precast section will be made ready. Curing will be done in flat slabs or in say any kind of slabs. Generally the curing is done by ponding method, but in precast you can also go for steam curing method, which is very fast and say high strength gaining procedure. So that makes your flat slabs. Where can you provide the flat slab? You can provide in any kind of building, say residential, institutional, commercial, public building, office building. Everywhere flat slabs can be provided, can be constructed, and it is one of the most simplest type of construction in different type of precast slabs. The second which we have is hollow core slab. Now it is one type of a floor, right? Hollow floor or ribbed floor is one type of a slab or a floor in which hollow spaces will be left inside. Now, what is the major benefit of this type of construction? It will be lightweight, right? As compared to the flat slab, the hollow slab will be lightweight. Less construction material will be used. You can provide it in any office building or school buildings. Provided the weight, the live load bearing capacity will be different as compared to the flat slab. The third one which we have is double T slab. Now we can see over here, I am taking my cursor over here. At top is the flat slab, but at the bottom T's are provided, right? So over here you can see it can be single T slab, it can be double T slab as well. So when you want to provide longer span, when you want to provide for longer span and more load, T beams can be provided. I am sure you have already studied about the design of the T beams. Although the design in the precast construction and precast members will be different as compared to the cast in situ T beams and T members. So over here, the third type which we have is a double T slab, or you can also have a single T slab. So the main use, the conclusion which comes at the last, it is used in floor and roof decks, right? So roof is also one kind of a slab, right? Although certain courses, weathering courses will have to be provided for the roof. It will be different than the regular floors, but these are the main uses of the precast concrete slab. Now moving forward, next we are going to take the second one, precast concrete beams and girders. The major concern over here is the beams, right? So let us try to understand the same. So over here we can see we have different shapes of beams. The first one is a rectangular beam. It is the most simple type of construction, most commonly used type of construction in any kind of conventional building. That is my rectangular beam. The second which we have is the section, the elevation, right? The cross-sectional elevation is L-shaped. So we have the L-shaped beam. The third one which we have is inverted T-beam. We saw double T slab in which the T was provided at bottom. Over here, this is my major beam, primary beam. This is my secondary beam. So this is my inverted T beam. The last which we have is Ashto beam. So we can see that the cross-sectional elevation is just like I shape. This is an example of a girder. You also know about RSJ, right? RSJ is rolled steel joist. You know that those are the examples of H beam made up of steel. And the similarly over here, we have precast concrete girders, which are known as Ashto beams. You can see over here that how the construction is done with the help of simple rectangular beam. You can see over here that here L beam is provided. This is inverted L beam, right? So based on the symmetry, based on the shape, based on the requirement, different type of precast concrete beams can be casted. Apart from this, we also have more different shapes existing. For now, we are studying the four of them. So it provides support to the slab. The major function of these is to provide support to the slab. Projecting reinforcing bars will bond with concrete on the side. So from this, you can also conclude that on-site concreting work, a little bit of concreting work will have to be done for providing the bonding between the existing two members, which are two connected members. Now, moving forward to the third type of construction, third type of precast concrete element, we have is wall panels and column. Now, students, see, I am flashing over here. This is my example of a precast concrete wall panel. Over here, this is also an example of a precast concrete wall panel. The walls will be constructed in the form of panels. Identical shape and size panels will be constructed, and somehow it also becomes easier to construct, because if they are identical in shape, then you can construct in bulk very easily. So over here, the openings, right? The openings for the doors and windows will be left. And this is how your wall panels construction will be made, and it will be placed directly on the side. It can be solid, it can be hollow, or it can be sandwiched with an insulating core. Now, insulating core comes in between in picture when you are talking about thermal insulation or sound insulation or any kind of resistance if you want to provide in a building, if you want to insulate it, if you want to make it, say, even water resistant. So in such cases, the walls are provided, the walls are given a barrier or insulating material in between. It is sandwiched between two panels, and that is how your construction will be done. So it can be solid, it can be hollow, it can have even the projections which you can see over here. There are many different cases of precast concrete wall panels. It can be ribbed to increase the vertical span capacity. Ribbed means the projected portion which I am telling you over here. Now, these are the example of a ribbed wall panel. Okay. Next, moving forward to the other elements, I am going to show you certain examples of precast concrete staircases. So the stair which you have over here, can you see that this is a precast section? The girders or these hinges are provided over here. It will be fitted. The joints will be fitted and it will be done fixing with the floor. Over here you can see that a precast concrete staircase is being lifted with the help of chains and hook bars, and it will be placed in its position. Necessary joints will be provided, it will be connected. So these are the uniquely shaped elements, or say precast concrete staircase. The stairs and landings make the ideal solution for fast track high quality concrete staircase construction, meaning you are going to use very high strength concrete for the staircase, because staircase is an important building component, and it is generally the one of the major say element when there is any kind of emergency in the building. So you have to always escape through that. So high quality concrete construction has to be done for precast staircase. Now, next we are going to talk about advantages and disadvantages of precast concrete construction. Now, you know very well that everything comes with pros and cons, right? There are lots of construction concepts available, but everything has its own pros and cons. So let us talk about say pros, that is advantages. Now I think you will be able to gather all the advantages from the two sessions which we have done till now. So first of all, it is off-site. The concrete is cast off-site, meaning on the site the space utilization will be lesser, so less space will be required. Next is identical forms can be used several times. See, I highlighted this point before a while, that if it is identical, then you are able to construct it easily. So in most cases, identical forms have to be designed. Better quality control, we discussed this point already when we were differentiating cast in situ and precast. Control on curing, controlled curing can be done, so less wastage of water. Unaffected by weather during casting. Now see, if there is monsoon season, then cast in situ concrete work doesn't work properly. You will have to wait because of the humidity, because of the snow, because of rainfall, right? Summer is considered to be ideal weather for cast in situ construction, so that is an advantage over here. It is of low cost. See, it is low cost after the construction is done, right? Once the initial cost is going to be higher, right? But later on, the cost will be very much lower. Waste materials can be used to, waste materials can be used, say fly ash or slag or asbestos, etc. can be infused in this concrete members, and you can gain more strength. That becomes the part of the admixtures. It is fire resistant. We have to design the concrete in such a way that it is fire resistant. It can avoid airborne pollution as well. Smog eating concrete is one of the new technique right now which is developed and which also absorbs the pollution. It can control it. So as I said, there is a lot of advancement in this field. About the disadvantages, we already know that handling and operational charges will be more. Large number of joints will be provided in the system. Obviously, how you are going to connect this concrete members with the help of joint. Expensive for small projects, as I said, it will be initially have high cost, requires skilled workers. It is required to design in detail the transportation and erection. As I said, this handling part is a bit tedious in this construction. It is less resistant to earthquake and wind forces, not recommended where seismic loads are acting, right? So for such cases, it is not recommended, right? Okay, students, so we will meet in next session. We will move forward in this particular topic. Till then, have a good day, students. Thank you.